Good evening. Myself Parag Yelegaonkar. I am heading business development in Testo India Private Limited, and I also look after the projects in Testo. Basically, Testo is a German company, and we have headquarter in Lenzkirch and TTZ in Germany, which is in Black Forest. We have 32 subsidiaries spread all across the world, and we also have India as a major largest subsidiary. And we also have a network in India for our channel partners, dealers, and associates. Basically, I will be covering after first we saw the finance and viability part of it, then we saw asset management, O&M, and now we will see little technology part, how we can find out the defects in solar from the cell manufacturing up to the plant and project level. So basically, this is a solar cell structure, the cut section, where you can see the aluminum frame, seal, glass, EVA, and Tedler film. This is a typical structure. Then this is a typical view of a solar power plant outside, and where we generate the power. This is basically a polycrystalline solar power plant. Here, I would like to emphasize on the thermal imaging usages to find out the defects in the solar cell as well as module, defects in the junction box, array junction box, and the inverter of the solar power plants, and also after inverter, this is the transformer, and up to the transmission line where we are feeding the power. So basically, it's an infrared technology. Whenever there is an object, it always emits electromagnetic radiations, and those radiations are absorbed by the IR sensors in the thermal imaging camera, and it can be detected any hotspots, cold spots, defects in all these components, electrical, mechanical components. We have different modules for solar photovoltaic system defect detection. We have important model is 885, where the thermal sensitivity is just 30 millikelvin, so that a minute temperature differences in solar module cells can be identified for the defects as far as the hotspots are concerned and the cold spots are concerned. These are the typical views, how you can see here the hotspots, how you can detect in a module, and whenever you see the hotspots, you can take a thermograph and do the analysis in the IR software that we provide along with the thermal imaging camera. Please note that whenever you do the thermography on any solar power plant, it is better to do the thermography from the backside, because on the top there is a glass, and any solar infrared radiations cannot pass through the glass. For that, typical germanium glass is required for the solar electromagnetic radiations to pass through. So preferably, if you find any defect from the top, just go behind the solar module and take another thermograph, so that you can easily identify the defects. And you can also find out the accurate temperature when you do the thermography from the backside of the module. These are some typical thermograms. You can find out the patchwork pattern, defective bypass diode, delamination defects that also can be identified with thermal imaging. Then of course the cracks. This is the typical problem when we receive the solar modules from the transportation. There is always a possibility that there may be some cracks. Some cracks may be left out during the manufacturing and pre-dispatch. Those can be identified. This is a bird's eye view of solar power plant, wherein you can see the thermal images and the thermal patterns. Please note that whenever there is a dust problem in your solar modules, you will get a higher temperatures. So whenever you get a higher temperature pattern from the top, you can conclude that there is a lot of dust is accumulated on the solar modules, and the panel needs cleaning. And whenever you clean the panel, you can see the temperature changes. After cleaning, the temperature goes down. These are the summary of typical defects on the solar modules. This is again a junction box, where there is a possibility of getting the hot connections due to corrosion, due to loose connections. So you can find it out in one look from the thermal imaging camera. This is a typical camera module we offer for the solar photovoltaic plant, where this particular thermal imaging camera has Wi-Fi and Bluetooth connectivity. With Bluetooth, it can connect the clamp meter, which measures AC-DC voltages and also AC-DC current, power, VA, VAR. So these parameters can be interfaced with the thermal imaging camera. When you take the image, all these parameters are recorded in the software, and also you can integrate thermohygrometer with this thermal imaging camera, so that you can also note temperature, ambient temperature and ambient humidity at the time when you take the thermal image. So this is a typical connections, Wi-Fi connectivity. This is a thermohygrometer and the clamp meter, which I already referred, the number of parameters you can interface. And all the parameters can be captured, and you can have a professional report within a minute, software generated, and the report can be sent from the site to your head office and to the concerned facility management people. These are the typical thermal images which we have taken from Dhule Solar Power Plant, 125 megawatt Mahajanko. You can see how the hotspots can be identified in the cells, and then the corrective actions can be taken. Either you can take out the module and replace it with a new module, so that it cannot damage the other modules in the same string or array. These are the typical problems in the
request for the last minute, please.
Also, there is a balance of plant equipments like transformer and connectivity to the grid. There also is a possibility of the hotspot, and you will lose the availability if it is not predicted earlier. That's all from my side. In case you have any doubt, you can ask me in the question answer session, and we have kept some of the instruments outside for the display. If you have any requirement or if you have a query, you can come back to me. Thank you.